There's also cultural examples that are associated with sort of larger events that have occurred. And one particular example that is somewhat recent is a major security culture lapse that occurred in July of 2012. At that particular event, this was at the Y-12 National Security Complex in Oak Ridge, Tennessee. Three particular anti-nuclear activists entered this facility, and the three individuals that entered it are not maybe what you might think of as nuclear security threats. One of the individuals, an 83-year-old nun, and then the two other individuals was a 63-year-old and a 57-year-old male. So these were relatively senior individuals, and they entered this facility that has a very, very detailed and rigorous nuclear security system. From a physical security standpoint, it is a very hardened system. They had actually just upgraded that facility with $200 million worth of additional upgrades for the security system on that facility. And all of that equipment was in place, but the equipment had been giving false alarms. There had been parts of the equipment that were alarming, and the guards had learned after a while to just ignore those alarms. Just don't pay attention to them, don't bother with it. These three activists made use of that. It's not clear whether that they knew about the fact that those false alarms were occurring, but they made use of that as a means to acquire access to the facility, and they actually moved all the way in towards a vault location where they actually painted slogans, anti-nuclear slogans, on the vault. So while they didn't actually get inside the vault, they got all the way to the door of the vault before anyone stopped them. That's a fairly serious lapse in judgment by the human personnel at the facility. And of course, we were lucky in a way that this occurred because these particular individuals were not terrorists. They were not a criminal group from the standpoint they were trying to cause harm. They simply wanted to make their opinions about anti-nuclear activities known. And so they didn't take any action that actually caused any harm to other humans. But it did, however, cause a lot of harm to the facility in terms of its continued operation. The organization that was running that facility lost their contract to run and operate this facility, which is worth millions to billions of dollars. And a lot of that is just because the guards that were there, the security personnel, were just bored. They didn't believe that there was a real threat, that the threat didn't exist. And because of that, they didn't take actions whenever things occurred. They also entered into a lapse where they just got used to certain alarms occurring. Now, of course, they're under much greater scrutiny at that facility, and in fact, the entire Department of Energy, U.S. Department of Energy complex, is in a shakeup over this. The U.S. Department of Energy might potentially take over all security forces at all of the U.S. Department of Energy facilities in order to try to eliminate this. Now, the problem with that is why did this occur? Who was responsible for this? Obviously, the answer is the guards had a responsibility, but most of us would say that that responsibility actually goes long, well beyond just those particular guards. It is really due to a cultural problem that existed both within the facility as well as within the entire infrastructure as a whole. And it starts with this basic concept up here of, did they believe that there was a real threat? And does everyone within the structure believe that? So what we do is we have to take a look at this and say that nuclear security culture is an important part of every security infrastructure. No matter how good your hardware is, without the people behind it, that hardware will not serve any purpose in securing those facilities. Those humans are very important.